This video is sponsored by SeatGeek. SeatGeek is a ticket app that finds the best deals from hundreds of sellers, separates the good ones from the bad, and even shows you the viewpoint from your seat. Use my code ezBUCKETZ off this app to get $20 off your purchase. SeatGeek, the best way to buy tickets. As I make this video, the Dallas Mavericks are currently ranked number one with the best offensive rating in the NBA of 117.4. They currently have the standing of 11 wins and 5 losses, tied for third place in the Western Conference, and also have a 5-game winning streak. This is all because of one player, and that player is Luka Doncic. Oh yeah, and also Kristaps Porzingis. But in this video, I'm not going to be talking about KP. I'm going to be talking about Luka, and why I believe Luka Doncic will be the face of the NBA. In other words, the player that will take over the NBA. Yes, guys, that is my bold statement. As of right now, it is pretty obvious that the player running the league right now is LeBron James. LeBron James is known as the best player in the world, and even though he's aging, he's still known at that caliber level. But we all know that LeBron will soon retire and would have to give up that reign of the best player in the NBA to somebody. And I'm telling you once again that I believe that player will be Luka Doncic. And in this video, I'm going to explain why. So yeah, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to a very special episode of ezBUCKETZ. If you love basketball, you are in the right place. And make sure to hit that subscribe button to not miss any of my upcoming videos just like this. So in this video, I've basically broken it down into 5 different categories. Each category is basically a subheading, and I'm going to be giving you guys reasons to why I believe that fact or that stat is important. But before I get into that, I just want to explain a little history of Luka. Luka has a really long basketball history. He has always played basketball. But just to sum up his career before he actually got drafted in the NBA, he was a big-time European player who actually won the EuroLeague Championship and MVP in 2018. He played in many European tournaments, was a part of many European Olympic teams, and was known as one of the youngest and best players in Europe. So when Luka decided he wants to take his talents to join the NBA and play against the American players, it really was a big deal. And because I'm making this video in his sophomore season, I just want to remind you guys that in his rookie year, he won the award of Best Rookie and Rookie of the Year. So now let's move into the categories. The title of this category is Acceleration. Luka Doncic is the fastest player to ever reach 2,000 career points among all active players currently in the NBA. Yes, guys, it took Luka only 88 games to get 2,000 points, while the other players that are behind him are Blake Griffin with 89 games, Joel Embiid with 90 games, and LeBron James himself with 92 games. That is one small record that Luka Doncic already beat, and 100% that record is going to be hard to beat for the upcoming future. After Luka won Rookie of the Year, we did not expect Luka to take such a major leap, a major jump into what he is doing right now. As I'm making this video, he's averaging 30.6 points a game, 10.1 rebounds, 9.8 assists, 1.4 steals, 0.2 blocks, 3.3 three-pointers made a game, shooting 50% field goal percentage and 82% free throw percentage. He is one of the youngest players ever to average a triple-double only in his sophomore season and only in under less than 20 games. That really makes Luka stand out from every single player in the NBA, and with him scoring 2,000 points in his first 88 games, being the first player to ever do that, proves that his future is definitely bright. Which moves to my second category, which is specifically about the coaching and the Dallas Maverick organization. The fact that Luka is getting all the touches, getting the opportunity to run the ball similar to a LeBron James or James Harden figure, it means that this organization of the Dallas Mavericks really trust him. The Dallas Mavericks do have a history of winning an NBA championship in 2011, so them making a young 20-year-old the main focal point of their offense is definitely not a risk, but it's something they're sure of. And when Rick Carlisle, the coach of the Dallas Mavericks over the past 11 years, have chosen to use this system, to focus their system, to focus their playbooks around Luka Doncic, that really means that not only will he be consistent at what he is doing, but he'll obviously get better because he is young and has more room to improve. And I 100% believe that Luka is nowhere near his prime because he's only in his sophomore year. And if Luka can excel and get better to what he is doing right now, then Luka is definitely going to be one of the best players to ever touch the basketball. The title for the third category is that Luka is breaking records already. He is the fifth rookie ever in NBA history to average 20 points a game, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists, joining the company of Michael Jordan in 1985, LeBron James in 2004, Oscar Robertson of 1961, and Tyreek Evans of 2010. Disregarding Tyreek Evans, he is among such great names in NBA history, and we all know about how LeBron James and Michael Jordan are referred to as the GOAT, greatest of all time. The fact that Luka is breaking these records and also helping the Dallas Mavericks win means that he is an effective player, because it is proven in the NBA that even though some players put up monster stats, they don't win. But in this scenario, Luka is winning. The Dallas Mavericks, as I make this video, are on a 5-game winning streak, and it could even get better. 100% Luka is gonna definitely end this season with way more points than 20 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists, which were his stats last year. And with his usage rate being over 35%, there is no room, but basically only room for him to get better, get more experience, and lead the Dallas Mavericks back to that championship conversation. When NBA reporters talk about Luka Doncic, they watch his play, they watch his game, and they always say, for a 20-year-old, he's one of the smartest players to ever play in the NBA. He is great at making decisions, and his step-back three-pointer is deadly. I'm actually making this video after watching Luka Doncic vs. James Harden on November 24th, when Luka actually won the game. Not only did they win, Luka actually outplayed James Harden, who right now is known as the best scorer in the NBA. And after that game against the Houston Rockets, Luka broke another record. Which moves to my fourth category, joining good company. He broke the record now as the youngest player to get a back-to-back 35-point triple-double game and joining company of Michael Jordan, James Harden, and Russell Westbrook, who are all NBA MVPs. He is the fourth player to ever do it, guys, but what's most important is he is the youngest. Imagine being 20 years old, putting up numbers, and being in conversations with MVP caliber players. That is a dream come true, and right now, Luka Doncic is living that reality. If Luka is breaking records when he is 20 years old, imagine all the other records he'll be breaking as his career continues. The sky's the limit for Luka, especially with Rick Carlisle and the Dallas Mavericks building a team around Luka. I see him as an NBA champion. And as of right now, if the Dallas Mavericks keep winning and Luka keeps doing what he is doing, he is definitely in the conversation of the 2020 Most Valuable Player. Which is why I had to make this video. Luka is an MVP caliber player 100%. And the title to my fifth category is simple. NBA fans love Luka Doncic. To become the face of the NBA or to be recognizable to players outside the NBA, you need to be loved, you need to be liked. Can I tell you guys a fun fact? In Luka Doncic's rookie year, he was actually ranked second in fan voting behind LeBron James to play in the All-Star Game 2019. And overall, he was ranked 8th. As a rookie being drafted second behind LeBron James by fans, that is a pretty big deal, even in the Western Conference. When players like Steph Curry, Kevin Durant, Klay Thompson, Damian Lillard, James Harden are also in that conversation. That is a big deal, and if Luka is getting that special attention in his rookie year, imagine getting that attention 5 years in the NBA when he's gotten better and doing better than he did in his rookie year. With all of the things that Luka is achieving, I genuinely believe Luka is the next face of the NBA once LeBron leaves. It won't happen in the next year or two, but it will happen within the next decade 100%. I really hope Luka is in the conversation for Most Valuable Player, and I really hope that the Dallas Mavericks keep winning, because guys, if you watch Luka Doncic, you'll love his game, you'll love his playing style, but most importantly, you'll love him as one of the best NBA players today. So yeah guys, that basically wraps up my video on why I believe Luka Doncic will be the face of the NBA. Just to conclude, he has broken many records to prove, and the statistics say it, that if he can stay consistent and healthy, he will get there and in that conversation of greatest of all time. But I want to know what you think. Do you think Luka has what it takes to become the best player in the NBA, recognized as the GOAT after LeBron James? Do you think so? If you don't, please explain why in the comment section down below. But if you do agree with me, be sure to smash that thumbs up button to show your love and support for me making this video. I can't believe that Luka Doncic, in his sophomore year, his second year, is already putting up triple-doubles on a nightly basis, and that just shocks my mind. But this basically wraps up my video, guys. I just want you guys on the same page that Luka is the future. And just a quick fun fact before I continue the video, Luka, through 88 games, has had more points than Kobe Bryant, more rebounds than Kevin Garnett, and more assists than LeBron had when they played their first 88 games. Now that is some elite company for sure.
But other than that, take it easy, God bless, and I'll see you guys next time on Easy Buckets. Woo! Hey, look at that boy, huh? Cooking up joints, like, running to school, huh? Like, you already know, never got help, so did it myself, doing so well, huh? I bet you can't tell that I've been. Money. Like this my dance.